Sylvia Kristel is a Dutch actress and model, born on September 28, 1952, in Utrecht and died on October 17, 2012, in Amsterdam. She is known for having played the main role in 5 of the 7 films, at the cinema, of the Emmanuelle series in the 1970s and 1980s. She first came to international attention in the early 1970s with Emmanuelle, 1974, for director Just Jaeckin. Then 2 more sequels followed in which she also starred. These are my top 10 movies for Sylvia Kristel. At number 10. Alice or the Last Escapade, 1977. One night Alice can't stand her husband anymore, and she decides to leave him. It's a dark, rainy night and something smashes the windshield, so Alice is forced to seek shelter in an old mansion. She is warmly welcomed, but soon realizes that strange things are happening. She tries to escape, but it seems there's no way out. At number 9. Red Heat, 1985. An American woman visiting her fiancé in West Germany is caught up with a defecting spy and captured by those in the East. After brutal interrogation, she is placed in a prison along with sadistic guards and inmates. As she tries to survive in a world of deprivation and rape, her fiancé fights his own bureaucracy in an attempt to find her. At number 8. Frank and Eva, 1973. The story of a man who goes out looking for hamburgers while he has a beautiful steak at home. Frank and Eva can't live together, but can't live without each other either. Frank has sex with every woman he can get, while Eva wants to start a family. At number 7. Game of Seduction, 1976. Charles is wealthy, a French venture capitalist in the 1830s. He's also an aristocratic assassin, prompting duels for political, monetary, and sexual gain. At his aunt's, he meets Madame Mathilde Leroy, a virtuous and beautiful woman, and he determines to seduce her. Along the way, his lust and game playing give way to love. One of his partners in crime and seduction, a decadent marquis, determines to break Mathilde's spell over Charles, sending her a forged letter that begins a spiral of tragedy. At number 6. The Concorde, Airport 79, 1979. Journalist Maggie Whelan, Susan Blakely, discovers that her married boyfriend, Kevin Harrison, Robert Wagner, heads a company that is involved in illegal arms sales. To stop her from going public, Harrison decides to kill her by bringing down the Concorde she is taking from Paris and Moscow. It is up to pilots Paul Metrand, Elaine Dielen, and Joe Petroni, George Kennedy, to keep the plane aloft and intact in the face of repeated missile attacks from jets sent by Harrison. At number 5. The Margin, 1976. Sigmund Pons, Joe D'Alessandro, is a successful businessman who enjoys a peaceful existence in the country with his wife and child. During a business trip to Paris, he encounters Diana, Sylvia Kristel, a beautiful and intriguing prostitute. Tragedy strikes when he receives news that his son died in an accident and his wife killed herself shortly afterward. In utter despair, the grieving Sigmund throws himself into a passionate affair with Diana and struggles to reconcile his guilt. At number 4. Emmanuelle's Love, 1993. Emmanuelle withdraws into a temple in Tibet, where she wants to find her true self. She's given a mystic substance that will give her youth and allow her to enter the souls of other women. Now she sets out and searches for her true love Mario from 20 years ago. When he sees young Emmanuelle, he doesn't believe it's really her, but she retells all the juicy details of her past to prove it to him. At number 3. Julia, 1974. It's summer, and the air is quivering with passion, as teenager Polly, who stays at boarding school, travels to a small seaside town to enjoy the holidays with his family. On the train, he gets to know the attractive woman, in whose compartment he sits down immediately after he has risked a glimpse into the section of the Sleeping Beauty. A little later, she vanishes and has sex with a stranger on the train toilet. He is thunderstruck at the train station when his father picks up not only him but also her. The unfaithful blonde, Yvonne, is obviously the mistress of his own father. At number 2. Mata Hari, 1985. Mata Hari is a beautiful Dutch-born dancer working in Paris. It is August 1914 and war between France and Germany seems imminent. However, she accepts an invitation to travel to Berlin as part of a show. On the train, she meets a young German army officer, but any thoughts of romance are cut short when a French agent is murdered on the train while in her company. She is arrested in Germany, but freed when the German officer intervenes. While in Germany, war breaks out, and she is recruited by German intelligence to spy on France. At number 1. Private Lessons, 1981. Teenager Philip Fillmore, Eric Brown, is out of school for the summer. His millionaire father is out of town on business, and he's got the mansion to himself, with the sexy Dutch maid Nicole, Sylvia Kristel, to keep him company. It sounds like a dream summer until Nicole starts acting strangely familiar toward Philip, who isn't quite sure how to react. Meanwhile, chauffeur Lester, Howard Hessman, seems to have something up his sleeve as well, which doesn't bode well for poor Philip. Worthy mention, Emmanuelle series, from 1970s to 1980s. Emmanuelle is a French erotic film directed by Just Jaeckin from a screenplay by Jean-Louis Richard based on the eponymous novel by Emmanuelle Arson, starring Sylvia Kristel in the title role, Elaine Cuny, Marika Green, and Christine Boysen. Distributed by Parafrance Films, this film was released on June 26, 1974, in France. It gave rise to a series of films and TV films featuring the same character.
Hey everyone, thank you for watching this video, hope you enjoyed it. Please subscribe, like, share, and I'll see you again in the future videos. Take care.